NetGuard is an application that allows you to control which apps on your phone can access the internet. Why is this important? There are several key reasons for using NetGuard. Firstly, it helps prevent data stealing by restricting background apps from accessing the internet. Secondarily, it reduces internet traffic, which can lead to lower cost when using mobile data, especially when Wi-Fi is unavailable. Additionally, it can help decrease battery consumption, among other advantages. You can find NetGuard on Google Play, but this version is tailored to comply with Google policies, so it can be considered a light version of the app. Therefore, if you want a full version, it is recommended to download the app from F-Droid. After installation, read and accept the terms of use. When the program is launched, you will see a list of apps installed on your phone, with icons for Wi-Fi and mobile data on the right side, allowing you to specify which type of internet the app can or cannot use. For example, you can set a specific app to use only Wi-Fi if you want to avoid using mobile data. If you disable both icons, the app will no longer have internet access. In addition to the apps you have installed, NetGuard allows you to restrict internet access for system apps. You can do this by clicking on three dots in the upper right corner, then select Settings, then Advanced Options, and enable Manage System Apps. Now, all apps that use the internet will be listed. The names of the system apps will be displayed in red, while non-system apps will be in black, making it easy to distinguish between them. It is important to note that some apps are interconnected, especially system apps. Therefore, if you block internet access for one app, it may result in automatic blocking of internet access for all related apps. For example, as you can see, if we block internet access for Google Play Store, it will automatically block internet access for all related apps as well. Also, do not block apps that need internet access to function, such as web browsers. Doing so will cause the app to stop working. Thanks to everyone who took the time to watch this video. I hope you find it useful or at least informative.